Okay, I'm gonna try this beer in a bag. I feel like it's a huge waste of plastic. Oh damn, this is really good. Here.
We're at the Qingdao Beer Festival, Asia's largest beer festival, where over 1,400 types of beer are served and over 6 million people visit every year. Qingdao is the city's namesake beer. In 2017, it was the third most consumed beer in the world, after American behemoth Budweiser and Snow, a Chinese beer only sold in China. But while Snow may dominate by sheer numbers, Qingdao is more internationally known. It is one of the oldest beer brands in China, started by Germans in the early 20th century. Today, it's available in over 70 countries and is the host of this really, really intense beer festival.
So
this place feels as if Disneyland Oktoberfest and Coachella made it and had a baby. It's a bit cheesy and we were hesitant for a couple of hours, but I think this appropriation of Western beer culture actually works. And what makes this place particularly awesome is that there's really good comfort food.
But the city's beer-making history goes back even further, to 1903, when the Qingdao Brewery opened under the name Germania Brauerei. At that time, Qingdao was a German colony, and the Germans built a centralized pipe system for drinking water, a rarity in China at the time. Water was piped in from the mountains, which, along with hops and barley, were the only ingredients in the beer. In 1916, the brewery was sold to the Japanese, and rice was added to the recipe. And in 1949, when the Chinese Communists came to power, the brewery became a state-owned enterprise. It wasn't until the early 1990s when the brewery was privatized and became the brand we all know today.
So you could say that, in fact, probably Japanese left a stronger legacy in terms of taste of Qingdao beer. But this part is actually wiped out by Qingdao people's memory. People would like to associate their beer with Germany, not with Japan at all. So this German legacy, to a great extent, is a kind of created, a kind of cultural construction.
In 1991, the first Qingdao Beer Festival was held. It now takes place every summer and lasts for about a month. In 2015, this site was constructed as a year-round ode to beer, and today it remains the main venue for the annual festival.
其实是青岛市这个市政府，就是政府，它有一个新的改变，然后它希望就是加强一下大家的夜生活，然后所以它让整个这个园区，然后没有官员，没有闭园，然后也没有说啤酒节闭幕了以后就没有活动这个样子。我们是不喜欢拿瓶子喝的，我们是拿袋子喝。
It's not the most environmentally friendly option, but plastic bags as a takeout carrier are very common in China, in part because they're cheap and convenient.
Qingdao people love to use their plastic bags. We were really amazed by how heavy these beer bags could carry. The largest one could carry 10 kilos of beer.
Qingdao beer also tastes better in Qingdao. Beer, after all, is basically liquid bread, and the fresher it is, the better it tastes. But the festival isn't just beer and food. There are dance performances, fireworks, a drone show, carnival rides, this eccentric pile of bubbles, and quite a bit of children.
It's been a complete sensory overload. One thing that really stuck out to me was how family-friendly the whole event was. There was no vomit on the street. There weren't people just passed out and falling all over the place. Everybody was perfectly fine, fully dressed, very respectable. It was quite strange for a beer festival. And the other thing is, we had seen a whole bunch of different cultures and performances from all over the world today, but you know what? No beer pong.
Despite the festival's popularity, locals say it is the beer, not the festival, that makes the city. In fact, Professor Shen says the first commercial ever made in China was for Qingdao beer in 1947.
是有一定规矩的，就是我们要靠喝酒来交朋友。就是这杯，如果我举起来，你干了，那么我们就会成为很好的朋友。
Hey guys, it's been a long day of drinking in Qingdao. For more alcohol-related stories, we actually went to a Baijiu factory in Sichuan. And don't forget to subscribe to Goldthread too.